Hi, I'm Som Seif, President and CEO of Purpose Investments. Well, 2016 has started not the way we all hoped it would. The markets have really had some volatility and some drawdown, and mainly driven by what's happening in China. And what's happening in China is a lot of uncertainty, a lot of fear. We've had a couple of things come into play. One, of course, we've seen some of the manipulation that the government put in place over the last 6 months kind of coming off. So the insider selling bans, they're starting to come off here. And second, a lot of the circuit breaker movements we've seen have really driven investors to start to push sales in the marketplace ahead of circuit breakers. But the biggest thing, in fact, is actually some of the movement that we've seen in the Chinese currency, the yuan. It's devalued somewhat dramatically in the last couple of days, and this has caused a significant amount of uncertainty and fear in the marketplace. So let's talk about this specifically. First, the Chinese government has been allowing its currency to sort of devalue here in the last couple of days, and this is really viewed as more uncertainty as to what they could do as opposed to what they actually have done. The Chinese currency has actually looked and gotten stronger in the last couple of years relative to its peers. If you look at currencies like the yen in Japan or the euro, the Chinese currency on a trade-weighted basis has actually gotten stronger. And this has been very negatively impacting the Chinese economy because the economy is an exporting economy. And what the Chinese government is trying to do is now get their economy growing. And what do? Just like everybody else, devalue your currency. And that's what they're looking to do. Now, this is not a bad thing. This is actually, in fact, a good thing for the long-term growth of both China and the world's economic situation. But over the short term, there is uncertainty and fear, and mainly because of the unknown. Well, 20, 25 years ago, the Chinese government made a major currency devaluation decision, and they devalued the currency by 50%. And that uncertainty and instability is what people are concerned about. Would China do something like that again? In my opinion, no, they won't. And the reason they won't is because they're now trying to establish themselves as one of the leading economies in the world and one of the reserve currencies, both from a perspective of global trade and global currency perspective. And so they would never do something like that. Yes, they want to see their currency lower, but I just don't see this them devaluing the currency significantly. In the short term, the markets are looking at this fear and uncertainty, and I think they're looking at this as significant volatility drivers for the marketplace. But in my opinion, the moves that the Chinese government does to devalue the currency will in fact be a very big positive for the long-term growth of the economy in China and ultimately the long-term growth of the economy globally. But realistically, as long as we see political interference in the marketplace, the way we've seen it in the last couple months and the last couple weeks, we're going to see this type of volatility in China. It's not going to be a smooth ride, but the moves that the Chinese government's doing with its yuan today, in fact, will play out in the medium and long term quite substantially and more attractively for the global economy.